In a digital age, protecting personal data is becoming increasingly important. If you want to safeguard specific data on your computer, such as text, images, videos, or potentially passwords you have saved in a text document, it is advisable to use encryption to protect this information. Encryption transforms your data into unreadable format, making it inaccessible to unauthorized users. Although operating systems like Linux or Windows offer encryption options, if you use this type of encryption, you will only be able to access the data within the operating system you used. If you want to protect your data while also being able to access it on all major operating systems, here is the solution. VeraCrypt is free, fast and open source encryption program that allows you to encrypt files, folders, entire hard drives, and it works on all major operating systems, allowing you to access your data regardless of which operating system you are using. After you download it from the official website and install it, you might feel a bit overwhelmed. I know I was. However, you will find the program is actually quite straightforward and user-friendly. The first thing you need to do is to create a virtual encrypted disk. To do this, click on Create Volume, then select the first option, Create an Encrypted File Container. You will get two options, Standard and Hidden. If you want your virtual disk to be hidden, choose the second option. If you want the disk to be visible, choose the first option. VeraCrypt will ask you to select the location where you want to save your virtual disk. After selecting the location and naming your disk, simply click Save. The next step is encryption. VeraCrypt allows you to choose the type of encryption. When you click on the drop-down menu, you will see all the options. Choose what you want and click Next. The next step is the size of the disk, how much memory you want to allocate to your virtual disk. As you can see, you can define the size in kilobytes, megabytes, gigabytes, and terabytes. For example, I will set it to 200 megabytes. Now you need to define the password. When it comes to passwords, it is advisable to generate a password or use something that is easy for you to remember, but ensure that it's a combination of letters, numbers, and characters. In addition to password, you can also set a PIN as an extra layer of protection. Fun fact, VeraCrypt uses random mouse movement to increase the strength of the encryption. So, move your mouse randomly until the randomness collected from mouse movement is fully loaded. Once the progress bar turns green, click on Format to format your virtual disk, and your virtual disk is ready. Now you're probably thinking, okay, what now? You can drag and drop the file you just created into VeraCrypt, or you can go to Select File and choose the disk you just created. Now you need to perform a mount, just like you need to insert a USB drive into the computer for it to work. You also need to tell VeraCrypt where you want the disk to be. So you need to select a drive letter from the list, which is how you want your operating system to recognize the virtual disk. If you accidentally forget to assign a drive letter, VeraCrypt will remind you, as just happened in my case. This label will allow you easy access to your encrypted virtual disk through File Explorer, just like you access any other disk on your computer. VeraCrypt will ask you to enter your password and potentially the PIN if you define that one. In a new window, your encrypted disk will open. Transfer all the data you want to protect to this disk, and that's it. Your data is now on the encrypted disk. When you finish using your protected data, click on Dismount or Dismount All if you have multiple virtual disks. A significant advantage of this method of data encryption is that you can put encrypted disk on USB or external hard drives. Even if you accidentally lose or someone steals your USB or external hard drive, no one will be able to access your data because it is protected by encryption. It should also be noted that VeraCrypt allows you to create a virtual disk within a virtual disk. This is known as double encryption. If you want more than two levels of encryption, you can also do that. You can make 2, 5, 10 or more levels of encryption, as many as you deem necessary to protect your data. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.